you won't have enough surface. This is why you need to use not cemented solutions. One of the biggest advantages of the screw retained restorations is to cement something on 2.5 millimeters abutment. Is with time it changes the color. If you screw on the zirconia, you'll have a problem. 0 degrees between the cementation can be a little bit more problematic. In most cases, no, it doesn't affect on the aesthetics at all. The only option is using these parts.
Hello to Uniqa Dental Show, where we discuss interesting cases and new procedures in the field of dentistry. Don't forget to like, subscribe and follow us to stay up to date. Today with us is Dr. Yaniv. Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Great.
So, Dr. Yaniv, what do we see here?
Today we'll discuss a case when we don't have enough space because of two things. The first one is the position of the implants, and the second one is because of the teeth where we don't have enough place between the gingiva and the antagonist teeth.
I see. So it happened because the teeth were extracted and then no implants were placed for a long time?
No, not because the teeth were extracted and the implants were placed. Because the implants were made with a surgical guide and the positioning of the implants was very palatal. Because of the position of the implants, you can see that you don't have enough space between the implant and the antagonist. And in the buccal area, you have enough space. But for the abutment itself, you don't have enough space to position and make the crown.
So basically you mean that the implant won't have a base strong enough to hold the crown?
Depends on what you want to do. If you want to make a cemented restoration, then yes, you won't have a strong enough base because you won't have enough surface for the adhesion between the crown and the abutment itself. This is why you need to use not cemented solutions. In this case, the doctor used a screw retained restoration.
So in this particular case, what restoration methods would you suggest? Or like, what are the correct restoration method to use?
We need to analyze it on two aspects. The first one is the height. If you choose between cemented restorations and screw retained restorations, one of the biggest advantages of the screw retained restorations is the fact that you don't need enough height for the abutments and the all the parts. In cemented restorations, you look here, you have 3.5 millimeters from the gingiva. So you'll have an abutment of about 2.5 millimeters. To cement something on 2.5 millimeters abutment is definitely going to be a failure because you'll have the cementation almost always. In this case, you have to do a screw retained restoration. Screw retained restorations, in these cases, you have two types of screw retained restorations that you can use. The first one is you can do a PFM bridge on those two implants, and the second one is you can do a zirconia bridge. PFM bridge, because it's in an anterior positioning, probably is not the best idea because you'll have some grayness in the gingiva. And in the frontal tooth 21, 22, you want it to be the aesthetic as possible.
Exactly, that was my next question. If it's frontal teeth, so from an aesthetic point of view, what restoration would give us the best result because it's frontal teeth and it needs to be, you know, on the top level?
In most cases, when you choose between cemented and screw retained in the frontal areas, the inclination of the implant goes into buccally. So if you want to have the best result, you probably would use a cemented restoration because in the buccal area, you'll have the screw channel. And the screw channel is closed with composite. With time, it changes the color and it's going to be problematic. In this case, you have the implants quite palatally. This is also a little bit of a problem, but you won't have the screw channel. So you'll have the screw channel, but it would be much palatally and won't come to the buccal. But if you use cemented restoration, let's forget about the 3.5 millimeters for the cementing. The finish line is supposed to be around the gingiva, because you don't want to cement the crowns, in this case above the gingiva line, because you'll have residues of cement around the crown. It's a little bit hard to clean it up and you have inflammation. So this is why this case is the perfect case for screw retained restorations and not cemented ones.
We know today more and more people want zirconia because it looks nicer and much more aesthetic. In this case, you don't have enough space. How is it possible to make zirconia maintain?
Zirconia crowns are not screw retained directly to the implant. In zirconia crowns, you have some cementation, because if you screw on the zirconia, you'll have a problem. You'll have probably the zirconia would break because it's a more ceramic-like material. So you need to cement something into the crown. Mm-hmm. When you're using zirconia and you're milling with CAD/CAM, you'll have 0 degrees between the sleeve that goes into the crown and the preparation of the crown itself. So it's much better than cemented restorations. Mm-hmm. In this case, when you making zirconia, you have it on multi-units. Mm-hmm. On top of the multi-units, you'll have a sleeve, and the sleeve will be cemented to the zirconia. So in here, when you have a 3.5 millimeters between the gingiva and the antagonists, you probably would use a 3 millimeter sleeve. It's not a standard height. Mm-hmm. The standard height is about 4 or 4.5 millimeters. But for this case, the best option that you would have is a little bit lower. The cementation can be a little bit more problematic. You'll need to have retentions inside the crown also. Mm-hmm. You would do it with your hands before the cementation, and cement it, and that's all.
Mm-hmm. And it will hold perfectly.
Yeah, it would hold perfectly.
It doesn't matter if it's a lower height, like non-standard.
The height is not a big problem. If you'll have a passive fit and the cementation would be fine, with the right materials, everything will be fine.
When I run the numbers, is 4 millimeters enough space for the zirconia crown?
In most cases, no, because when you're using screw retained restorations, mm-hmm, in standard parts, the minimal height of the multi-unit is around 1-1.5 millimeters. There are companies that the minimal height is 1.5 millimeters. So when you have about 4 millimeters, you can't do screw retained restorations at all multi-units. And the minimal height of the sleeve is about 4.5. So the minimal height that you'll get all in all, including the multi-unit and including the sleeve, you'll have about 5 or 6. In this case, the multi-units that were used was 0.5 millimeters, and the sleeve is 3 millimeters. So you'll have a height of the metal is about 3.5, mm-hmm, and you'll have a little bit more for the zirconia. The thickness of the buccal part is good enough to have great aesthetics. Mm-hmm. And on the occlusal part, you'll have about 0.5, I think, millimeter for the zirconia. It's okay. It's not the best, but it doesn't matter because it doesn't affect on the aesthetics at all. So this case was made probably because of the smallest multi-units and the smallest possible sleeve that can be done. Because of this, you can, in 4 millimeters, have a screw-retained restoration on multi-units, something you can do with standard types, multi-units and sleeves.
Which will give you a good aesthetic result as well.
Yeah, you'll have greater aesthetic result because the multi-unit positioned quite palatally, you have a lot of buccal space for the aesthetics. The only problem in this case, if I look at it, is the palatal position of the implant.
You mean the angle of the implant?
Yeah. If the angle was a little bit buccal, you could have made a cemented restoration and it would be nice also. But in this angle, it's impossible, mm-hmm, to have cemented. It's very hard to have screw retained restoration. Doesn't matter what type of restoration. So in this case, you have the only option is using these parts if you want to have good aesthetics with the zirconia bridge.
I see that in this case, scan abutments were also used.
Yeah, if you want to do zirconia, it's impossible not to use scan abutments. Everything is digital. You can, mm-hmm, see by the models it was made on exocad, and the bridge was designed and later milled. You can't do zirconia without kind of abutments.
Intraoral scanning and CAD/CAM is an interesting topic. I think we will do another video about it.
Probably, it's a huge topic.
Thank you very much for being here today.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being here today. Don't forget to like, subscribe and follow to stay tuned to the latest cases. Thank you and have a great week.